Hey y'all, what's up, what's up, what's up, YouTube? It's your girl True, and I am back with another one. Disregard all of that that's going on in my background. I'm in the midst of cleaning up. Y'all know when y'all clean up, you get more junkier. Y'all know how that shit go. All right, so we gonna hop into this message. If you're new to this channel, head on over, hit that subscribe, hit that bell, because I know you're gonna love this energy. If you returning and you gang, you already know how we do it over here on the channel, baby. Let's get started, okay? I don't know what tonight's message is gonna be about. I do know that it's the I call it the pre-New Year's Eve day. I know y'all probably like, what the hell does that mean? So now I see a lot more people talking about like how this is not the new year. 10 years ago, when I used to try to tell a lot of y'all this was not the new year, people didn't like none of my posts. But then I was around another different type of people too. So they probably was like, True, what are you talking about? This is the new year. This is what we always know. But I've come from a tapped in background family where we kind of like always been different. I don't know how to explain it. But anywho, my mom has always told me for years that the actual New Year's is in March. So for me, I use this time to kind of prepare for the actual New Year. So this is like the pre-New Year, New Year, New Year. Y'all get what I'm trying to say. Get into this message. I don't even know. Let's see what spirit says. What's coming towards us? So I heard next 48. So I heard, let's do the next 48. So this is what's coming towards us in the next 48. Because this is a future reading, you know, we won't know exactly how much it resonates, but still drop me a comment of love, still like the video. It helps me out and our tribe channel out, right? And put us in the algorithm and help the tribe grow. Okay, so I love all of you guys for supporting me. Thank you all of you guys for liking the video. Thank all of you guys for taking the time out and drop a comment. Understand, like, y'all, my spirit team, they seeing who fucking with me, right? I'm knowing who going with me to the top, okay? Who really going to the top, all right? let's get it. So I just got a download, and I was gonna try not to say it, and they was like, no, this is a download. So there's somebody on here. Before I even pick up the cards, you're elevating and you are being elevated to the top. You're going, you're slowly moving, or it could be, you could be ascending faster, however, you know what the hell I'm trying to say. But somebody that's ascending has someone in their background, right? And this person is coming off like, oh yeah, they fuck with you, but they don't really fuck with you. So let me give you an example, okay? This is, you're going to be a millionaire off of your products, right? Let's just say you make natural skincare products, right? This person is always in your energetic field. Y'all probably always talking, always. But this person don't never tell nobody you got skincare products. When anybody talk about skincare products, this person don't bring you up. This person ain't sharing your skincare products. When you post them, they not, you know, hey, y'all, you know, pop, helping you, but they, when you get to the top, this person thinks you about to take them with them because they're just staying close to you, but they're really a close hater. They're really not trying to pop their shit for you, okay? I had to learn this firsthand. I had to cut so many people out of my energetic field because they were close haters. And I'm gonna be 100 with y'all. It hurt my heart. It was people that I was helping, trying to turn into, turn into their better, their highest self, right? But I was like, I was looking at them like, you know, they like a little me. Like, I seen where they are now is where I used to be. Okay, that's where, you know, that's where I feel like the little me thing came from. And I'm like, it was like three different people and I held them close. And I had to realize firsthand that they never shared my shit. They didn't pop shit for me. Like, I would, like, anybody know me? No, I'm steady sharing people stuff. I'm steady telling people about other people. Oh, you need somebody to do this. Oh, you need somebody to do that. I know somebody to do this. I know, like, I'm always trying to get my people out there. But this person was really just trying to suck up my energy, right? And thought that they were going to coattail and leech off of me. So when I get big, you know, and they pop out, they can pop off of my following and what I just have to struggle and build. Somebody thinking that they're about to do that to you. Your spirit said they got another thing coming. Be mindful of those people. And this is for anybody. I don't care what you do. If you doing nails and you got a homegirl and she ain't out here popping the shit for you, letting you pack, she ain't asked you for no business cards to go pass out at her workplace, because that's free. That's free. It don't take nothing to be like, oh, my homegirl do nails. It don't take nothing to be like, oh, my homeboy cut hair. Oh, my homeboy detail cars when you see somebody that got a dirty car. But you stand in this person's energetic field trying to eat and leech off of them or probably even get free services from them. Let's talk about it. But you're not popping your shit for them. So this is the wake-up call for my chosen ones. Somebody has a leech. Somebody that's very close to them. That's just trying to leech off of their numbers, their money, or their clientele, or their clouts, because people do that too. I literally see girls that go with other girls and put other girls on a pedestal just because of the way that they dress or the clout that they have. That ain't no real friend. I had a friend, y'all. Y'all know I get story time. And y'all, this friend was a friend since fucking middle school. Y'all, so I'm thinking that this is my, you feel me? These new bitches, this my day one day. But when I seen the new bitches, let me not say bitches, but the new queens, goddesses, right? I seen the new girls. I seen the way she was react. Like, I was just there as an extra income for the trip. We just gonna put it like that, okay? And it hurted my fucking feelings. I'm not gonna lie to y'all. But I needed that to realize that I be holding people on pedestal thinking that a mother, because we like this. And that motherfucker just... You get what I'm trying to say? So I need a lot of us, especially if you're an empath, especially if you're a chosen one. A lot of times we be putting people on pedestals in our life that really don't deserve to be on that pedestal. That's half-ass popping they shit for you and leeching so much off of you. It's time you pull your energy back. It's time you find out who your real friends is, family is, because the same. Just because this person has the title of a family member and they were born into blood, that does not give them the okay to leech off of you. That does not give them the okay to not pop they shit for you. It's time to cut, cut, snip, snip. And I'm telling you, every time I cut anybody off, my numbers leveled up. Why? Because everything is energy. And those leeches leeching off of me was holding me back. They were weighing me down. Y'all getting what I'm saying? I was getting pulled back until I started to... I'm weeing out the leeches. I'm weeing out the ones who just in here around me. You get what I'm trying to say? But they not really popping their shit for me. Okay? I don't know who this message was for. But it's time to cut, cut. It's time to snip, snip. They can't go with you to this next level. They didn't put in all this work that you put in to get where you getting, to get where you at now. They damn sure can't go where you about to go, baby. You thought you wasn't, and this is work, baby. You thought you was about to piggyback off of me? And I'm out here blood, sweating, and tears? No. All right, y'all, let's get in this message. Let's get in this message. Y'all know them channel messages be coming through. Y'all know I heal y'all all the time through my stories. All the time. All the time. I tell y'all I'm only the dopest healer that I am today because I don't judge nobody. I don't judge nothing. And I genuinely move out of love. And I ain't trying to leech on nobody. I'm out here doing this work, okay? Out here doing this work. And I know my tribe out here too. If you just tuned in, let's hop on board and do this work too, baby. Because it's onward and upward over here in this tribe. Do you hear me, gang, gang? Y'all already know. Y'all already know. And if you made it this long, you a real one. I just want you to know. You a real one. Give you your flowers. Here you go, boo-boo. Thank you for really fucking with True. All right, y'all. Let's get into this message. Let's get into this message. Spirit team, guardian angels, archangels, all of those that are for my highest and greatest good. I call upon God himself. I call upon Archangel Michael for protection. My mother, Oya, for protection. As I step into these different energies, let's see what spirit has for us next 48 hours. What's to come? What's going on? My lips was almost crusty again. I caught it though. Y'all seen that last video? I had to try to lighten it up a little bit. Y'all, my lips was my lips was so damn crusty, y'all. So crusty. I'm like woozy right now a little bit because I was channeling. So the energies is, we got the Emperor card, the Emperor energy. So the next 48 hours, some of us could be having an Aries coming towards us. Does not have to be. But the next 48 hours, it's giving. Remember when I told you, like, somebody is around here, like, leeching? I'm getting, for somebody specifically, that story, this person that's trying to leech off of you, I'm getting that it's not done subconsciously. Like, they're consciously doing this shit. Like, oh, yeah, I'm going to try to string this person alone because, yeah, like they're playing chess moves behind it. But what they don't know is that I'm getting that you're going to be in this Emperor energy and you're going to put your foot down. Yeah, you're going to put your foot down and it's going to cause this person to go into hermit mode. This person is going to be a little bit confused, like, damn, what the fuck did I do wrong? But I want to get the story a little bit more. I'm just basing this off of the channel message that I just received. But here nor there, Spirit is telling me to release the channel message with what's going on here. Give me 1 second. Okay, so I'm hearing that just overall energy, a lot of us is going to be setting our boundaries and putting our foot down. You know, a lot of us, we were, you know, just let a lot of people walk over us, right? We didn't have boundaries, firm boundaries. We weren't fully loving ourselves. We wasn't fully going within and loving ourselves. But I'm getting that. A lot of some things that happened, and the things that happened to us recently, it caused a lot of confusion. Like, we was really confused. Like, a person could have just left and fucking ghosted us, and we was really sitting up here like, well, what the fuck did I do? Like, I was that bad of a person? Like, you just got on me like that? Like, or you and a person just had an altercation, but you was just really confused about the fight. Like, what the fuck? Like, you was just like, you was really scratching. You see how she's scratching her head? Like, that's the first, like, you was really like you was really confused. Like, you couldn't, like, your brain was like two birds, but like, you really couldn't figure this shit out. Like, you couldn't put your finger on it if you tried. And it caused some of you guys, or a lot of you guys, to go into this hermit mode. And this is right before the new year. And this was supposed to be what's coming in the next 48. So I'm getting that in the next 48, you're gonna set your boundaries down with a lot of people because of this situation that happened in the past. But the situation that happened in the past only happened so you can set these goddamn boundaries. You get what I'm saying? Yeah. You dealt with the Knight of Cups energy for a lot of you guys. A Knight of Cups energy, and this does not have to be a male, right? I want you guys to understand that it can be a female energy in her masculine energy if she's out here in masculine energy. Y'all know what masculine energy is, right? So basically, this Knight of Cups energy is a person who's, they want love, but they don't really know how to give that love, right? Like, they have a lot of healing to do in order to even project the love that they're wanting, right, onto them. And because of that, they cause a lot of confusion within you because they're still confused within themselves. That's all that was. But this confusion needed to happen, right? This confusion needed you to go into hermit mode, right, that you went into. So you can start setting your boundaries. You could have also been dealing with the Virgo, because hermit card is Virgo energy. And this is Aries energy. So you could have been dealing with a Virgo or an Aries. And it caused you to really go deep within and really, really, really deeply heal. But I want to just see a little bit more and see what spirit has. Yeah. So all of this that you went through, I'm getting it caused. So this is something that you had to walk away from, something that had to end. With the Ten of Swords, like, this is a complete cycle ending. Like, you walked away from it, ain't no coming back. Like, you done, you good, you feel me? I'm done. The Eight of Swords is chopped, it's screwed, chopped. I literally heard chopped and screwed. but for things to come together. So I'm hearing you had to walk away from something for something to actually come together. You had to dead something completely for it to come back in together. Now, it could be this specific person that you had to walk away from and chopped and screwed, and somehow they put them screws and chops back together, right? Or you just had to come together with something greater and grander. But things is definitely coming together. Things is definitely coming together emotionally. But in order for them to, a lot of you guys need to set y'all boundaries. And a lot of you guys need to fucking completely walk away. Yep, y'all got the Wheel of Fortune right behind it. So I'm getting the energies that whatever state you're in right now, like if you're single next year sometime, like you're going to be taken. If you're low, your finances is low. No, you're going to be up. Like it's going to be complete 360. This 360 is going to be a 360 of leveling up, okay? So everything that's taking place with the Wheel of Fortune and the 10 being here, with it's literally 10s back to back. So you could be seeing 10-10. You could be seeing 11-11. You could be seeing 1-1-1. And that's because you're about to have to walk away from some shit. Some shit is about to end, but it's about to end because it's about to level you the fuck up. The shit that you were holding on to, it was just pulling you back. You wasn't really pouring into yourself with the Star card being here. You was not. And the Page of Wands, I'm getting the energy. You was like trying to hold on to something that was dead. You was holding on to something that was dead and gone. And because of that, and you wasn't releasing it, you wasn't in this, oh, you can go energy. I don't know why this Page of Wands just give me, you can go. It give me, you can go. Like, you can go energy. You wasn't in this, you can go energy. It caused you to have to really go within and start healing. But in the next 48 hours, I'm definitely seeing a lot of you guys are going to be coming together with either an Aries or a Virgo. And let me see what else is here. We got air energy here. Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, Virgo, and Aries. Virgo and Aries. Yeah, so I'm getting an energy with the Five of Cups. The Five of Cups came out like this. I'm getting an energy that... let me put these cards right here. Y'all want to see the cards? Y'all don't ever see the cards. Y'all can see the cards. Y'all don't never see the cards. Y'all want to see the cards? I'm a big old kid. But... with the Five of Pentacles coming out here, this is like feeling left out in the cold. You know, somebody really left you out, like really did you wrong. Somebody could either even gotten put in out of a spot, okay? So I am seeing somebody getting put out of their spot, okay? I want you to take what resonates, leave what does not. I want you guys to remember that I read for a lot of people, okay? So everything within the message may not resonate with you, as I am picking up on a lot of different energies, okay? But somebody specifically, you may get put out. Like, they just drew me to this key that I barely even noticed that was back there. And she like, it's like she getting put out. But what she did, the thing that spirit wants me to let you know, you getting put out is actually you opening up some doors for you. Okay, so I'm getting the energy that you, wherever you were, or whomever was allowing you to stay there, it may have been hindering you. It may have been holding, may have held you back from actually leveling up, right? It was a hindrance. It was, what's the word I'm looking for, spirit? I can't think of the word, but like a hindrance to you. I think I was saying the word hindering. They were hindering you. I think I was. That's the word I was looking for. So, but I'm getting the energy that this getting put out is going to level you up, especially with the 10 of the Wheel of Fortune being there. And the 10 is definitely going to... it's definitely going to level you up. It's just going to create, it's just a change. It's just a change we're going to have to get used to when this person does put you out, okay? But here nor there, things is definitely going to come together. I just heard someone may also get put out because they don't want to have a threesome relationship or have a threesome with someone specific. I literally just looked over and literally seeing like somebody is going to not feel comfortable or something within the relationship, or they're going to get kicked out. Like, yeah, be mindful of that, y'all. Be mindful of that poly shit too, especially if your relationship cool and y'all happy with each other, right? 9 times out of 10, you don't need that poly shit for real. You do not need that poly shit for real. Yeah. So what's coming towards you, for a lot of you guys? We got the chariot. We got the Tower card. And then we got the Four of Swords. We got the Chariot, the Tower, and the Four of Swords at the bottom of the deck in that order. So we got air energy, Cancer, Scorpio, energy here as well. But I'm definitely seeing that somebody is going to come towards you guys. If y'all allow this person to come back, this person is going to cause a tower moment. I'm seeing a tower moment with the tower being here. This person is going to cause a tower moment, and it's going to cause some deep, extensive healing. So I'm not saying don't let this person back, right? You might need to let this person back because there's something that you need to learn from this person. But for specifically some, and this could be whoever got put out, right? Does not have to be, but this person is about to try to come back in. They're about to try to come they dog self back in, and I'm getting cause a tower moment. They about to try to, yep, in 5 weeks. It literally fell out right over the fucking car. In five weeks or less, this, oh yep, they about to try to get you pregnant too. That may be the tower moment. You got pregnant 5 weeks or less. Stay at home mom, natural healer, must do a cleanse, do not read. All right. Okay. So basically, somebody on here, you need to do a cleanse, okay? You need to definitely do a cleanse. I just picked up on your energy. So my spirit team is telling me to abort. I need to do some cleansing. So I had to make sure if this was for me, my space, or I had to sit here with it and see if this was for y'all. I'll be having to check. But I did tap into somebody's energy, just a second ago who had an energy attachment. And I want you guys to remember that I don't just read cards, right? You have some people who just read cards and they don't have the calling that I have. So entities is not going to attach to them like they try to attach to me. Hence why some people can go and, excuse me to get y'all off of this reading. But I want to just explain energies, you know, a little bit to you guys. Because I know a lot of readers and people, they connect differently. And a lot of people be trying to tell other people how they connect and how what they're doing is wrong. And when everyone is, it's no rule book, right? It's no book into what you're, it is a rule book, spiritual rules, but it's no rule book into, oh, if you are a reader, if you are a psychic medium, you're supposed to medium like this. You're supposed to connect like this, or, you know, whatever. Well, no, that's not the case. But I do want you guys just to educate you guys on what type of reader I am and how I take on energies. Basically, I don't read everyone. So sometimes people will inbox me and I won't be able to even open a message. My spirit team will tell me no, that they have an entity attachment that's deep, and that they only was sent to me because that entity is trying to attach to me. And because I'm not just a card reader and I have a high spiritual ranking, a lot of different people's entities that are attached to them try to attach themselves to me, right? They won't do that to everyone. Hence why you can see other card readers, they can read all damn day and nothing happens. They don't feel any type of energies or nothing because they don't have this direct connection. They're literally just putting together some cards. You get what I'm trying to say? But because I'm really opening up and I'm really connecting to those different frequencies, I have to really be careful. I have to really protect myself from the demons that's on you guys. Not like that, but I want you guys to know we all carry demons. It's just the matter of how deep. And if you're taming your demons, we'll be able to know if I can work with you or not, if that makes sense to you. So I do want you to know that. I hope nobody's on here have watched my videos like, she ain't inboxed me back. You might just need to do a cleanse, beautiful. You might just need to do a cleanse. Do a cleanse. Holla at me again. And I may be able to get to you. I don't want anyone to feel any type of way, right? Don't feel like, oh, I got an entity attachment. No. We all have the lower energies on us, and we all have higher energies on us, right? Just think about your actions, right? Think about what you are doing in life, right? Are you doing the right thing? Are you moving out of love? Are you being selfish? Are you being greedy, right? Are you being petty, right? Are you trying to hurt people physically? Do you get a kick out of hurting people? Are you just being weird, just being evil for no reason? So there's people that literally just be weird and evil for no reason, but that's because their vibration is low. Like, their vibration is low. I'm in the midst of learning some things right now. Spirit is putting me through some some learn. So I'm gonna come back with some motif for y'all when it comes to the different energies. But I've been, y'all know I learned everything hands-on, and y'all know I just started reading, what, 11 months now? So I'm learning things hand-on, like literally how to work with energies, how to protect myself, how to protect y'all, and so forth. And I had to realize, I had asked Spirit, like when it first happened to me, I'm like, so how the fuck am I going crazy? And this motherfucker had the energy on them and they wasn't going crazy. But it's because they're living in that energy. I have raised my vibrations to a certain frequency where I would literally get to shaking and shit. Like, y'all see me going into controls if I'm around lower energy. So anywho, somebody energy I just tapped into, they had lower energies. So Spirit is telling me to cleanse it up, to clean it up. That's another reason why I have not been live on my Facebook, because there was someone with lower energies that either, I think they got a reading by me, and then somebody else, there were two people, they kept getting on my live sending me their energies. Like, I'm very sensitive to energy, so if somebody is just sitting on there like, she ain't good, I hate her, oh I hope she gonna make it, oh I hope her live don't get past 50 views, oh I like, if there's, I can feel, I literally will feel it, I will start to hear it too. Like, so when y'all see me on live and I'm like, and I'm kind of all over the place because I'm reading minds, I'm connected to source, then I got some of y'all answers, because they know, like, this is another thing too. When y'all get to y'all gifts, I'm gonna let y'all know. This is how I know. Like, when y'all get to y'all gifts, okay, and y'all really tap in fully, Spirits is gonna be like, over here, y'all. Like, it's gonna feel like, hey, y'all, she know we here, y'all. Come over here. And then they gonna be coming like, can you relay this message to my crossover loved one? They gonna be coming like that. Like, we get little snippets and peace. We feel the energies, and it all depends on what psychic gifts you have, right? Depends on how you can connect to the other side. Everyone has a different gift. Some of us hold all of the gifts, right? But yeah, that's how it is. That's how it is. So when I be live, I be having the energies from the outside world. I be having the energies from the spiritual world, the energies from my own world. You get what I'm trying to say? So I'm like, so I'll be looking at other, and I'll be like, okay, how the hell? And that's when I had to realize, because when I first started reading, y'all gotta understand that I don't use the word compare at all, but I analyze everything, and I put together, and I take what I need to take, and I leave what I need to leave out, right? Spirit of life has been my teacher for real. So when I used to, like, remember looking at other reading, I'm like, how did they? But then I had to realize it's levels to this shit. Then I had to realize, oh, a lot of people picking up these, and they ain't even should be doing this shit. Okay, because how the fuck I gotta do all of this, and they don't, right? But that's because they own me so tough. And it's another thing I want to tell y'all for my chosen ones. If you chosen, it ain't gonna be easy. They gonna be on you. You gonna see everybody else numbers shooting up. You gonna be like, what is, I'm the real deal. Why they don't see me? Because you got to remember, we amongst all this low energy. So it's going to take a while to break through these demons. I don't know who this for, but Spirit is saying, keep stepping on next, because you destined for greatness. Your shit didn't happen overnight, baby. Huh. Because big shit don't happen overnight. Do you hear me? When have you ever known an elephant to be born in 9 months? Oh, because elephants ain't regular, baby. Do you hear me? They not regular, baby. So think of yourself as an elephant. They're one of the smartest, one of the largest, one of the largest. And if you over here in this tribe, yeah, I'm sorry. But if you over here in this tribe, baby, I need you to listen to me from the bottom of my heart to the top of my crown. You destined for greatness, baby. I need you to keep going, keep stepping on next, and you do not stop. You do not let up. Do you hear me? Okay, because I thought you said you didn't hear me. I said you're destined for greatness. Why are you over there thinking about giving up? I don't know who this is for, but I feel like I'm channeling right now. Why are you even thinking that route? I ain't gonna be on you too hard. Because it's been a couple times, these demons, they out and went live about 6-4 months ago. And I could tell you, I was going to throw all my cards away. Because I felt like, do this. I'm going to be homeless trying to heal the world. Nobody wants to. Nobody really think it's supposed to. Literally. going crazy. They had me thinking like, oh, this ain't my calling. I ain't supposed to be doing this. Don't let these demons stop you. They ain't supporting you right now. I promise you, they're going to be trying to sneak through the back door when you on top. Keep going. Keep elevating. This is only the beginning. Y'all already know what it is. As long as you move out of love. And I'm talking that genuine, heart-shaking, groundbreaking, world-stopping love. You're gonna always win, baby. Peace.